It's August the 28th, 2014. You are listening to the Nuclear Proctologist, and we are streaming live at Beautiful Girl Boy Dana on YouTube. And we are an organic movement. And what we have done here with the nuclear industry is we have flushed it out over a long period of time. There's a couple of hundred videos here, about an hour long each, where we cover all the headlines. And roughly around 9,000 headlines. We cover academic journals, the models, the Fukushima nightmare that it is, extensively in every shape or form. And we're just waiting for the stream to come up. And we're doing an early stream because we got a lot to get to. We're going down and pick up the boat tomorrow. I'll show everyone the boat. And the original Punisher, Jeff Palko. And I was on the phone with Jeff, bless his heart. What a good soul, you know, folks. He's contacted the shop, so tomorrow we'll have that picked up, and Saturday we'll have a little video out to show everybody us playing around and getting the kinks out of it. We'll hit a few beaches locally, and then we'll get ready for the run up the north coast, up to the Northwest Passage, and then we can have a debate, right? That's all we're asking for. Make sure the audio is good over here for everybody. I got quite a story for everyone tonight. I got threatened, set up today, threatened, harassed. That's okay, don't worry about it, I'll get past it. It's just shocking, and it's disappointing that people that actually own a sporting shop, so the guy up here, not that guy behind me, he was really something else. And, Jessica Stevenson in Powell River is apparently who set all this up on me. And they arranged for me to come down to the shop, and they wouldn't consider that there's 5,500 species missing from the coastline. And so what you're going to find out when they... I'll give you a sample of 16 beaches that we covered. Right, we covered... That's up at Lund, working our way down the coastline. Now, the one above me is what it should look like, and the one on the long side of me... And I decided to go about this the easier way after that picture there, and just run through the beaches to show you what all 16 beaches that we landed on, we couldn't find a normal population. And just let me refresh everybody's mind on what a normal population is very quick. And because it's going to be a short video tonight. And tidal zones, BC tidal pools. Anybody who's anybody knows what a tidal pool looks like in British Columbia, you can go down and easy debunk me. I gave you all the beaches, the names of them, the places. You won't see any sea anemones. There's 600 algaes. We're only finding around four. There's probably a couple of pieces of bull kelp we found, but no kelp fields off the coastline. You can see what a normal looks like, right? It's very vibrant, full of insects, full of sea anemones. There's 64 species. I'm sure there's 70 species of sea anemones and 64 species of sea stars. We can only find purple. And we're honest if we get... This is what it should look like, what you're looking at now in its natural habitat. I'm just going to give you a quick couple of pictures and come back to the desolation on the 16 beaches we found. And you can see all kinds of life. Everywhere you look, there's life. It's magic. The ocean is just magic. I spent 14 years diving both oceans, Atlantic and the Pacific, extensively. We usually find these everywhere. Rocks are covered with them, and snails, different types of snails. And we found all together around the whole coastline was around 12 species, I think we identified, but nothing like you're seeing right there. Let's run back and I'll show you what we did find. So I just wanted to get you up to speed. Here's the last beach. Now this is taken from the ocean side, close to the ocean towards land. And as you can see, it's totally just got a few species barely hanging on and clinging on to anything. And these are a part of the 16 beaches. That one wasn't that clear of a picture, but everything else was. That was Wellington Beach and Powell. We just wanted to show that the life in the tidal pools is all missing. The feeder fish like tuna and salmon and codfish and rockfish and crabs, they're further up the food chain. They're not the filter feeders. But the filter feeders are usually clinging to the pylons. That's at the ferry down at Gibson or at Saltry Bay. You'll see nothing clinging anywhere. And that the rocks are all smooth. We're missing all the habitat and the life and the 5,500 known species, and there's around a million of them, but everything is missing. There's no babies, no eggs. I mean, I put all the names there for people to find. We found around, like, symbolic around 10, 12 pieces of each species, maybe on the odd ones. And then we found the four dominant ones, the two kelps, the indigenous mussel, and then the purple starfish. Now, we're not saying the fish are dead yet, but they're going to be dying because Fukushima is hemorrhaging 1,000 tons, or say 1,000 pounds a minute, a radioactive, extraordinary, unimaginable radioactive material into the ocean every minute, 1,440 minutes a day, 365 days a year. So it's a plume a minute coming into the ocean. If it was just one plume, I'd still be worried. And there's 1,440 plumes a day going into the ocean with no end in the future. Now, the currents and the studies and the academic studies, even from Japan, have shown, and you can go over to nuclearproctologist.org and look up all of this stuff. It's all available, and you can go over and see it from all the mainstream media because we got it all aggregated there. But most people got their heads hid away in fluff. I want to finish off those beaches very quick. This was zoom shots on the ferry on the coastline. We didn't see anything but the same vegetation, but we didn't see any marine life, only the four species. You see the kelp, right? What I call cabbage kelp. And then there was the kelp weed. You can see a couple of little pieces. And then there was the mussels. And then the only thing extra after that, we didn't even find more than a cupful of flies along the whole coastline. And anybody can go to the beaches. We found in total maybe 100 purple starfish in 9 low tides over 9 days and 40 kilometer boat ride. And I can understand how people can't wrap their mind around it. And it's just that they want to use violence on you is really, it's really, really, really nutty. And so I'm going to play that clip for you of them finally snapping. And remember, in a business in Canada, you have to phone the police to remove somebody from your property. You can't threaten to do what they're doing to saying to me. They're using a technique now of just being bullies and thugs and monsters to a guy in a wheelchair. It's unimaginable, but here we go. We'll play this little clip for you, yeah?
How do you take that work for?
Go get some fucking water, put it in a fucking vial, go get it checked and bring it to me.
Go do it. Go fucking do it.
Get out of my parking lot before I kick your fucking head in.
Yeah, you would. A guy in a wheelchair. You're going to hit a guy in a wheelchair, are you? Nice one. You threatened me. I got you, man. You're a moron. Fucking moron. To hell with you.
And you can imagine this. This is insanity. I'm in a wheelchair? And I can outwork all them put together, bitch. Whatever. But I'm just saying. You know, all I asked was, the whole point that he got mad at me was because after 10 minutes, he admitted in anger that he didn't watch the video like he said in Jessica Stevenson's video. This maniacal thing that set this all up and hid away and didn't even show up. Sent me messages, said, we're all waiting for you. Nobody was there except for two thugs. And they're trying to drive us and stop us from going and looking because they could make money. They got a lot of money in it and they don't want anything to happen to it. He kept saying, we got people coming into the shop all the time. Like, does he have any concept of what a low tidal zone, the nursery of the ocean? If you can't even wrap your mind around that, we're in a lot of trouble. And that people like that out there are going to get disappointed in the very couple of next weeks because we're going out. And see that see offshore? The whole coastline is like that. All of British Columbia. I dove it for almost 14 years. It's everywhere. On both oceans. But BC is extraordinary. You can't get to the shoreline on that stuff there. But now you can anywhere. And all you're finding is the same samples everybody else is finding. We got reports all over the island now, Vancouver Island, the same thing, Tofino, videos of course and pictures. And now we're going to go out in the boat and we're going to load say 800 pictures every low tide up to our site and we'll find out. And I hope I'm wrong. I truly do. Trust me. I hope. And if I'm wrong, everybody's going to yell at me forever. Everybody's going to be mad at me. I have people like that whack job today, that monster, willing to hurt somebody in a wheelchair who obviously can't do anything. My bones are brittle. And a girl, an ex, set me up rather than see us succeed. She wanted them to hurt me and I couldn't go do this. She wanted that knee-jerk reaction. She does cocaine all the time. Asks me, do I know anybody get cocaine? I don't know anybody. And I don't judge her. But to do that to somebody in my position is shocking. It's frightening. It really truly is. That the very people you're supposed to be able to talk to and have reasonable expectations of, because I sent her over and over replies that, but did you check the tide zone? What about the 5,500 missing species in the tide zone? Do you think I faked the pictures? Do you think we faked everything? And then said, here, this is where we went. Now anybody can go down with a camera? Do you think we're... And then had try to get someone to hurt me and be violent with me and threaten me and intimidate me. It's not going to work. But it could have if they had followed through and they were going to. They chased me out. He probably swung at me or kicked at me. He almost headbutted me twice. And I got it all on video. And I just don't want to go down that path of that animosity, this nuttiness. But this is what we're up against. And so we got to find a way forward to talk to these people because they need the help the most. And yes, they're going to be angry. And yes, they're going to lash out at us. And yes, they're going to even probably hurt us. But that doesn't mean they're not entitled to have an opportunity to get their loved ones and themselves out of the harm's way. They've done this in the Chechia River, 7,500 communities. It crosses the ocean 131 days. And every day behind it was another plume of 50 square miles. It's over 1,300 days. It came over in a disposition, washed back down to the coastline from the radioactive fallout. Go over to nuclearproctologist.org. Right? And we're victorious. I got home devastated, and there was an email that I can go pick up the boat. And I called up the boat shop, and he said, yes, we're just talking to Jeff, and he's got everything organized and arranged. We're looking forward to meeting you tomorrow morning, Dana. And then Jeff calls me up and says, don't forget to get rope and spotlights and radars and sounders and big suits, Dana, before you go. Don't go with everything, Dana. And so what they done to me in Powell River and what this crazy woman who's, I hope, finds a way forward done to us made us stronger. And hopefully now this will help us in what we're going to do if we find out what we think we know for sure at this stage. After 9 beaches, if the ocean don't seed one of them with babies everywhere, yeah, the ocean is broken. And we'll go document it and let everybody else, the university, the people who put us in this position in the first place, who told you it was like a banana, or walking in sunshine, we'll try to find a way to move forward with that. Right? We got 4 melted reactors, Unit 3 and Unit 4. Unit 3 is 2 million times worse than any other reactor on the planet when it comes to the fuel they were using, the MOX fuel. Now, that makes it 18 million times bigger because of its size and the 100% meltdown. Chernobyl was a 30% and was one-third the size and was used in graphite. But that's 18 million times worse, see? And that cooked all the phytoplankton and then everything else dies behind it. Because once you take out the popcorn of the ocean, because that's what happens, a Becquerel will destroy. And these, we're talking about 2 million Becquerels. Are 2 million times worse than every other reactor released into our ocean and into our environment and disposition up into our lower and upper troposphere. Like I cover this so extensively to meet people like that are willing to attack me, who know the ocean, rather than go down and look. It's frightening. It's frightening. And here you are, you got someone with Dana Durnford in my sight. And that's probably Jessica Stevenson from Powell River. But they're making accounts up to try, even though we're talking about 5,500 species missing. Here they are attacking me. And because who knows for sure how far we'll get. But everything is missing in the first 200. And people like this, they're just a innocent bystander, and you can't blame them for being idiotic like they've done today, because that's how they got everything they got, is they're thugs. But we still got to try to help them come to terms with what they're going to find out in the next few weeks, and everybody else on the planet can have a debate, and who knows, you know? Okay, so that's it. Where tomorrow morning we'll be on the boat taking it for a test ride. They got several different zodiacs there. We've looked at most of them. But we'll be there and we'll be coming out of there ready to go, and we'll find out. And I hope they're right. I really do. That'll be cool, folks. Hugs for everybody. 9 days. That's because I've been on the ocean all my life, Dina. It's not hard at all what we've done. We put a map to every place. You can go to a nuclear proctologist and do it probably in less. I'm crippled, remember? And you're a coward because you're using my name and you have to hide away to do that. You don't have to, you can't man up. You have to hide away. And so that's okay. You do what you got to do. We're going to do what we're going to do. And, you know, hopefully you come to terms with what you're trying to do. It's not right for a paycheck to come out and not give this planet an opportunity. Try to keep it alive for an extra paycheck. That's not going to happen. Your pensions are all gone. We'll catch everybody on Saturday. We'll come out with a video from the ocean, from the Zodiac. Maybe before that, you never know. But certainly, we'll get to a live stream Saturday night and get everybody back up to speed and ready for the big expedition for life. And we will categorically check everything in a 4,000-kilometer zone that we're going to cover. And then we're going to go to the Northwest Territory and check it up there. And so that's our side of it. And your support means it's going to get done now for sure. Right? All the extras, all the little bits, that's guaranteed. And Jeff, of course, we're going. Period. Hugs for everybody. Don't despair. We got a lot of good things coming up in the near future. Once we find out what we're up against, we know, but we got to prove it to everybody else. Hugs for everybody. Take care, folks.